Good evening. New South Wales has recorded its deadliest day of the pandemic, and the number of people in hospital continues to rise. Tonight, with our supply chain buckling under the strain, new exemptions are in place for critical workers in a bid to ease stock shortages at our supermarkets.
Saturday night in Sydney, and no singing and no dancing meant no people. The latest restrictions to try to stop COVID wreaking further havoc, hopefully.
There is no doubt for our state that this is a difficult time.
The other weapon, rapid antigen tests. 50 million have started arriving. Another 50 million are on order for essential workers, schools and the vulnerable.
From mid this week, the advice I've received from Service New South Wales and from New South Wales Health is that you will be able to register that positive rapid antigen test through your Service New South Wales app. The registration of a positive rapid antigen test will be mandatory.
But most of us will have to find our own supply. The government, though, believes more should be in shops and pharmacies in coming weeks.
Thousands of people are in a position where they want to find out whether they've been infected with the disease and they can't get access to a rapid antigen test.
With more than just rapid tests in short supply, critical workers in the food, logistics and manufacturing sectors have now been granted a special exemption if they are close contacts, able to leave isolation if they have no symptoms and test negative.
If you're asymptomatic, then we want to be able to make sure that you can go to work in those most important critical areas of our economy.
But the transport union says workers won't be safe and supply will still grind to a halt as more people become sick.
This is absolutely reckless from the New South Wales government. We know, the health advice has told us, the close contacts are the most likely in our community to be carrying the virus. And just because they're asymptomatic, it doesn't mean they can't pass it on.
Too late for KFC stores at Emu Plains and Glenmore Park in Sydney's west, closed until tomorrow afternoon because of a shortage of chicken. An email to staff saying there has only ever been one day each year in the 12 years we have been in this business that we have closed our restaurants, and that is Christmas Day. There were 30,062 new cases reported today, with 1,927 now in hospital and 151 in intensive care, 38 of them needing a ventilator. But there were also 16 deaths, 8 women and 8 men, the highest daily toll of the pandemic. Among today's positive cases, the New South Wales Governor Margaret Beasley and her husband. She was seen at the pink test 2 days ago. With increasing numbers of people presenting to hospital, staff are urging the community to leave emergency and 000 for only the most urgent cases.
We know that over the next 3 or 4 weeks where the system will be under strain, it won't be perfect. But I have confidence that our health staff will do the very best job they can.
Clarification too on how COVID-positive patients are treated in hospital. Those who present first with another illness, say cancer or a heart attack, will be treated in isolation on those wards to get more dedicated care.
We just don't have enough separate wards and isolation rooms with negative pressure to actually separate people once that community prevalence becomes very high.
At Sydney Olympic Park, the constant urgings to get a booster are paying off. People have been just walking in to a seamless operation.
Just trying to get my booster shot, trying to do the right thing, I guess.
Honestly, anyone who doesn't get it, I just have to say, get it. It's so easy to do. That little few minutes out of your time to save your life.
If you need it, you need to get it. And you should get it. Anyone who doesn't get it is a bit silly, I think.
And with daily numbers climbing nationally, preparation, it seems, is also the key.
It's likely that many of us will test positive for COVID-19 over coming days and weeks. My advice is that you make sure you have some paracetamol or ibuprofen at home.
As for the Premier, no doubt hoping his COVID headaches won't get too much worse before they get better. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
The Premier has declared students will return to the classroom as scheduled, despite surging virus numbers. It comes as the long wait for children to be vaccinated finally ends, with those aged 5 to 11 eligible for the jab from tomorrow.
5-year-old Hazel Lewis is busting to finally bounce into kindergarten when she starts school next month.
And what are you looking forward to the most?
Playing in the park, painting, and playing with my buddy.
But that milestone moment amid Omicron is making mum Sonia nervous.
I remember my first day starting kindergarten, and you have all those fond memories of forming friendships, and I just really hope that it's not put on hold for them.
Queensland today announced it will delay the start of its school year by 2 weeks.
It is not desirable to have our children back starting school during the peak of this wave.
But in New South Wales, day one, term one is locked in.
We are completely committed to doing that.
Easier said than done, according to the Teachers Federation. Masks, classroom ventilation, and the return of home learning if there's a teacher shortage caused by sickness, just some of the many issues that haven't been settled.
A lot of things should have been sorted out. We need to look at rapid antigen testing. Procurement issues aside, how may rapid antigen testing be used as another line of defence in terms of infection as a part of a risk mitigation strategy?
There will be bumps along the way. Once we've finalised those plans, we'll release them to the public so that parents right across the state can have confidence.
Omicron is less severe. We can manage. I think it's possible to get as many children back to school as possible.
Part of the nervousness surrounding the start of school is that the vaccination of 5 to 11-year-olds only starts tomorrow, meaning many young students won't be fully vaccinated until at least March. And that's if you can get an appointment, with many vaccine hubs around Sydney already booked out.
There are multiple options. It could be your general practice, it could be another general practice. Pharmacies.
Please take the advantage, come and get forward for vaccination. If you haven't booked already for a vaccine for your child, please do so now.
Davina Smith, Nine News.
COVID outbreaks have sent nearly 500 aged care homes across the country into lockdown and infected more than 1,000 elderly residents in the past 3 weeks. The Health Minister says booster jabs are being rolled out to 2,600 residential facilities ahead of schedule.
At this stage, we have over 1,500 that have received the boosters, and all facilities have either received the boosters or are scheduled on the advice that I have from Operation COVID Shield.
The number of infected aged care staff has also jumped to 1,800 nationally, causing major workforce shortages.